Hi, I'm Dr. Nick Askey with Airrosti Rehab Centers, and today we're going to be discussing a very commonly diagnosed condition, which is shin splints, and also other conditions that tend to mimic the symptoms of shin splints. We're going to discuss anatomy, mechanism of injury, and the traditional medical management of shin splints. On the other hand, we're going to discuss how Airrosti is different and how we resolve shin splints and these other conditions rapidly by treating the cause of the problem rather than just the symptoms associated with it. Next, we're going to use this chart here to show the anatomy behind shin splints, which is actually a very rare condition. And we're going to contrast that with the other contributors of shin pain, which are actually much more common. All right, first we're going to start with shin splints. Shin splints is defined as an inflammation of the attachment of what we call the interosseous membrane. The interosseous membrane is a thick sheet of fascia between your two shin bones. And how this inflammation occurs is with an old ankle sprain, which will rotate the bone in your ankle called the talus. And when the talus rotates, every step you take or every impact you have, it will spread these shin bones apart, which puts stress and inflammation on this sheet of fascia. This is actually a very rare presentation because it takes a very severe sprain to rotate the talus enough to cause shin splints. In contrast, what many people mistake as shin splints is actually a tendonitis of the muscles that cross the ankle. There's one on the inside called tibialis posterior. There's one along the front, which is tibialis anterior. And then there's one on the outside called the peroneal musculature. And when those muscles get inflamed and irritated, they can mimic shin splints. Also, you can have stress fractures down here in the tibia. You can also have what is called as compartment syndrome, and that's also misdiagnosed as shin splints. So now we've differentiated between traditional shin splints, which are rare, and these other more common conditions that can cause shin pain. The causes of these conditions are overtraining or ramping up your training too quickly, running with poor running form, gymnastics, dance, cheerleading, these sports that are done on unstable surfaces, and old untreated ankle injuries and foot injuries. Now that we've discussed the anatomy on a chart, we're gonna show you on Amanda, our volunteer, where patients typically present with pain with traditional shin splints and with these other more common conditions. So the typical patient comes in the office and says, "Doctor, I have shin pain, I have shin splints." And when they typically point to where their pain is, it is in this strip here on the middle side of the shin, coming around the arch and into the foot. Now it doesn't have to be in this whole strip, just in this line here. And the most common cause of pain in this tendon and muscle is collapse of the arch or overpronation. They can also have pain in the front here, which is the tibialis anterior. And the most common cause of this pain is heel strike running form and working on an unstable surface. If someone has traditional shin splints, in the rare occasion, they complain of deep pain in this strip right in front and down in the front of the ankle. Traditional medical management of shin pain is what we call RICE, or rest, ice, compress, and elevate. You're going to be told to ice the area and stay off of it for about 6 weeks. In severe cases, you may be on crutches or a walking boot. In either case, you aren't gonna be working out very much for about 6 weeks. In contrast, at Airrosti, we're fixing the cause of the problem rather than just taking weight off of it or prescribing anti-inflammatories. So we're gonna be treating the fascial tissue in the lower leg, the ankle, and the foot to clear out the cause of the problem. And then we give you preventative strategies and rehabilitative exercises to prevent further injury. Now to wrap things up, I'm gonna give you a few tips to prevent shin pain. First, don't just jump into an exercise program. Gradually ramp up your activity to avoid injury. Second, go into a local running store. Get fit for the proper footwear for your activity. And lastly, make sure that we're stabilizing these old ankle injuries. If you have an old ankle injury or you currently have shin pain, come on in, call and schedule an appointment. We'd be more than happy to evaluate that for you. Thank you so much for watching the video today. We hope that the information presented was beneficial and useful.